Hello there, this is 8 Feet Under, yeah. Or Nate. This is the second video today, and the second video in a, like, I don't know, 5-minute time period. So, anyway, we have just... I just found out that the new...
Yeah, he's in the river.
The Scar-H has been added to the Druid testing area, so I thought I would give it a spin, and I'm already in love with it. It's pretty awesome. So, let's go over the stats. So, first off, it does 36 damage for a body shot. Or 75 damage, I don't know. Does 36 damage for a body shot or arm shot, I guess, on these guys. 75 damage for a headshot. And yeah, that's pretty good. So it can one-hit kill bloodsuckers. If you get a headshot, of course. Going for headshots is pretty easy. It is semi-automatic, but if you saw the first video about this, you'll know that.
There might be people up there.
It's not good for taking out the riot zombies, but there's not very much that is good for taking out riot zombies, so I'll leave that alone. Or I guess the RPK and minigun are the best things for that. If you hold down the trigger, you can fire it in automatic, but... But it's still pretty slow, around 350 RPM. So, anyway, yeah. So the ammo is 20 rounds in the magazine, 40 rounds in reserve, which is quite low. It costs 60,000 Dread dollars, and it's... Yeah, it costs 60,000 Dread dollars. And it is rank 17, which is Diamond 2. So I think that's a bit overpriced for like the damage and what you're getting, but that's fine. Because it is a really good gun. I think it'll be very good in like player versus player. And probably better than the AWP, which is 40,000, so... It is pretty long range.
Oh,
it still does full damage at this range here, which is around, I don't know my Roblox ranges, but it seems to be around,
I still don't
know my Roblox distances, so.
Nice sniper, though.
Yeah, pretty long. You can spam it and it's still accurate. I'm just going to turn down the volume a little bit, that's pretty loud. Mm-hmm. It's pretty much everything you'd want in a gun, except, you know, it's not very useful against these riot zombies. Except it does take him out in 7 shots, so that's pretty good. Come on. I would kind of prefer that it would have, deal 40 damage instead of 36, just to round it up, but then... That doesn't really matter too much.
Yo, what the? I'm gonna
say that it's pretty useless in Juggernaut, just because, well, why would you ever use this in Juggernaut? It has low damage, and it has low damage to the body, and that's not really what you want for Juggernaut. Here's the Wikia page, so...
Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'll just use it in Juggernaut just for the sake of showing that it's not very good in Juggernaut.
Soccer scan, dude.
I'm very excited to use this in like player versus player environments because, well, let's be honest, it's going to be pretty effective in player versus player. If it gets added to gun game, I don't know if it will. Probably will not, but it might. It will most likely not, though, so.
Oh, nice. I'm getting the rebate.
See, it's almost doing full damage. It's doing full damage at this range. Which is pretty insane, because there's no real other gun that does that. Oh, there's another person who is online. Didn't even know. Mm-hmm. I just want to keep this guy in the water.
Just
keep him in the water to get those easy shots. Huh. I did kill him. Okay. Well, if you're in a populated server, the Juggernaut, it's going to have a lot more health, and it's going to be quite a bit harder to kill him. So, anyway, I guess that's pretty much it. I do think the price is a bit too high, but besides that, it's a very solid gun. Good DMR-style weapon, even though it's actually a battle rifle, but, well, it's a battle rifle, but with a lot of qualities of a DMR. Yeah, hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe if you want to be updated with more, updates on Dread. Thanks for watching. See you next time.